To go. You guys ready? Sad not to go with the candles, huh? Yeah. Come here, buddy. And just stay right here. I was waiting for her to come down. Go sit next, to Arlene, okay? Go sit next to Grandma.
Please rise. Be seated. Well, good evening and welcome to a beautiful, albeit unusually cold and wet Arizona evening as we gather together as witnesses of the powerful bond between two people who are well loved. Usually when you arrive at a significant moment in your life, you can look back and see the moments and the steps that have led you to that particular moment. And most of the time, those stepping stones, if you will, involve people. And so each one of you has been invited here to this special moment tonight because in one way or another, you've been involved in the shaping of this event. Because of your valued relationships and your influence in the lives of Chris and Amber, you've all been invited here tonight by no coincidence, but with purpose and intent to be a part of this special occasion as two people begin their journey as one. Amber, you are about to enter into a relationship with many privileges, but also many obligations. The man that you love is about to become your husband. Your love will be his inspiration, and your support will be his power and strength. Will you love him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live? Chris, you too are about to enter into a relationship with many privileges, but also many obligations. The woman that you love is about to become your wife. Your joys will be her joys, and your sorrows will be her sorrows. Will you love her, comfort her, honor her and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Who now gives this woman to be married to this man?
The mother and I.
I don't know. Come on.
Woo!
You ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Anybody got tissue in their boobs?
Chris and Amber, what tokens of your love and commitment do you have to exchange with each other this evening?
Good luck, buddy.
Thanks, buddy.
Chris and Amber, in just a moment you're going to exchange vows and your rings, but before you do that, I'd like to share briefly about the significance of our wedding rings, because unfortunately our rings are something that kind of lose their symbolism after a while. We wear them every day on our fingers. We forget they're there. We just take them for granted. We may take them off and we do the dishes and set them on the kitchen sink and forget about them for a few days and then panic when we remember they're not on our finger. But they lose their value to us after a while, and that's unfortunate because there's a lot of symbolism in what you're doing with these rings in just a moment. One, you'll notice that your rings are made out of precious metals and precious stones. I'm sure as you have paid off or are still paying off your rings, you're very aware
still
of how precious
still
how precious these rings are. We exchange rings made out of precious metals and stones for a reason, because it symbolizes that the commitment that you're making to each other today is of extreme value and significance. It's not something that's cheap. It's not something that's to be entered into cheaply or hastily. And it's not something that's to be given up on. It's making a commitment to another human being for the rest of your life is the most valuable thing that you will do in your lifetime. The second thing you'll notice is the rings are a complete circle. There is no break in them, and that symbolizes that your commitment to each other is to have no break. Now, I know this is hard to believe, but there will come times in your life where you might not feel as in love with each other as you do at this very moment. Now, everybody that's married in the audience laughed at that because they realized the truth in that. Your love will come and go for each other because love's a feeling, but your commitment that you're making to each other tonight is what's to get you through those times where you don't feel as in love with each other as you do at this very moment. It's your commitment that's to get you through those low times in your life and in your marriage. in ancient days, when a king would put a decree into law, he would take his signet ring. It was a ring with his initials on it. He would dip his initials in the hot wax, and he would take that parchment paper and stamp his initials onto that parchment paper. And once his initials were stamped onto that parchment, whatever was written on it became law. And once that happened, the king himself could not go back on that law. And in a way, what you're doing tonight by exchanging vows and your rings, you're putting your love into law. You love each other. That's what got you to this moment. But now you're making a commitment to each other. And just like the king could not go back on that law once his initials were on it, so the two of you are not to go back on your commitment that you're making to each other tonight. Chris and Amber, it's really my hope and prayer that your rings would not lose their significance to you, that they would not lose their value to you, but that they would be a daily reminder of your love for each other. It'd be a daily reminder of this moment, and it'd be a daily reminder of your commitment that you're making to each other.
Are you nervous?
A little bit.
Chris, do you now take Amber to be your wife?
I do.
Repeat after me. I, Chris.
Hi, Chris.
You might want to look at your lovely bride.
Oops.
There we go.
We'll start.
You're married,
Chris.
The officiant.
Again.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Take you, Amber.
Take you, Amber.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today.
I love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And forever.
And forever.
I will trust you.
I will trust you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh with you.
And cry with you.
And cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best.
Through the best.
And the worst.
And the worst.
Through the difficult.
Through the difficult.
And the easy.
And the easy.
As I have given you.
As I have given you.
My hand to hold.
My hand to hold.
So I give you.
So I give you.
My life to keep.
My life to keep. Come on, girl, push it. That's me.
Amber, do you now take Chris to be your husband?
I do.
Amber, repeat after me.
Sorry.
I, Amber. Take you, Chris.
Take you, Chris.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I'll cherish our friendship.
And love you today.
And love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And forever.
And forever.
I will trust you.
I will trust you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh with you.
And cry with you.
And I'll cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I love you faithfully.
Through the best.
Through the best.
And the worst.
And the worst.
Through the difficult.
Through the difficult.
And the easy.
And the easy.
As I have given you.
As I have given you.
My hand to hold.
My hand to hold.
So I give you.
So I give you.
My life to keep.
My life to keep.
Yours was shorter, I think.
I don't think so.
It seemed like it took a long time.
Well, when I first met with Chris and Amber many months ago, I asked them if they wanted to do something that I do in weddings called I Love You Because. And what I asked them to do is to write their statements to each other and send them to me. Their reasons why they love each other without sharing it with each other. Now, whenever I ask a couple to do this, I assume that you've heard at least once or twice why you love each other to get you to this moment. But they chose to do that, and it's a way for them to express themselves in this moment and just share their reasons why they love each other with you. Now, I don't know if this takes anybody by surprise, but they did not email them to me. They just gave them to me last minute. I don't know if
that surprised anybody. Oh, man.
But they wrote a few things that they love each other for, and I'm going to read to Amber what Chris wrote to you first.
Okay.
Amber, Chris wrote these words. Amber, I love you because of your strength and your independence. I love you because of your punctuality. I love you because you put up with all my crazy friends. And finally, Amber, I love you because of your beauty inside and out. Chris, Amber wrote these words. Chris, I love you because you're the most honest, loyal, genuine person in the world, and we are all lucky to have you in our lives.
You had to blow mine out, huh?
That's what I do.
I love you because you tell me the best stories in your sleep.
Oh, man.
I love you because no matter how early we leave to go somewhere, we are always late.
Yeah. Because of you.
Please.
And finally, Chris, I love you because you are everything I'm not, and you make me feel beautiful every day.
I hope it stays that way.
Chris, I'd invite you to take Amber to behind the table here.
Yeah, we got going now.
Well, understanding that all couples face rough spots in their marriage, Chris and Amber have chosen to do something to help them when that time comes. Chris and Amber as a couple have found a wooden box and a bottle of wine. They've also written two love letters to each other stating the reasons why they love each other. And I'm going to give those to you each right now. They feel those and they haven't shared with each other what they wrote. Chris and Amber, I would ask now that you put the bottle of wine and your love letters inside the box and then shut the lid.
Whatever you want to do, baby. I know. Get in there.
Oh. Or just leave it open. there's a life lesson in that.
Give me that.
Chris and Amber have agreed in front of all of you that if they find their marriage enduring serious difficulty, that they'll lock themselves in a room, they'll open a box together, they'll drink some of the wine, and they'll read their love letters to each other. By doing this, the hope is that they'll be reminded of this day and the reasons why they fell in love with each other. Of course, the hope is that they'll never find themselves with a reason to open that box. And if that happens, then the box will be open on their 25th wedding anniversary, and by that time, both them and the bottle of wine will be well-aged.
I'll go that way. There you go.
Well, Chris and Amber, you have affirmed before your families and your friends your love and devotion for each other. You have come from different backgrounds. You have walked different paths. You are different individuals. Yet your love has transcended these differences. In the years before you, may the richness of the traditions that have nurtured you enhance and brighten your lives as to help to create and shape your family's future. May the challenges of your life together be met with courage and optimism. May you learn from your failures and may you grow in your achievements. May your life together bring you happiness as friends and family become a wide network of mutual support and enjoyment. May you face life's pains, toils, and troubles with a stout but a light heart. May you share with others the radiances of your seasons of joy and pleasure. May you always remember that laughter truly is the medicine of the soul. And may the spirit of love ever be a part of your life so that the union that we celebrate here today will be worthy of continued celebration today, tomorrow, and forever. Well, for as much as Chris and Amber have pledged themselves in the presence of this company and have spoken the words and performed the rites which unite their lives, I do now, by the powers vested in me by the laws of the state of Arizona, and more importantly, by your love and commitment to each other, pronounce that you are husband and wife. Chris, I don't know if you would have such a desire, but if you do, you may now kiss your lovely new bride. Well, it is my privilege and honor to be the first to introduce to everybody here Mr. and Mrs. Chris Price.
Oh my God. I'm out of here.
Everybody for coming and joining them on this special day. We would ask that you stay and celebrate with them. There will be people that will lead you as you go down this aisle to the left.
When the breeze went up my skirt.
That's a little wild.
Allow me to. Too much time is never enough time to be spent with you. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, it's true. You're no ordinary girl. Yeah, you always speak your mind. You're no ordinary girl. Yeah, you're one of a kind. You're a falling star, you're the getaway car, you're the line in the sand when I go too far. You're the swimming pool on an August day, and you're the perfect thing to say. And you play it coy, but it's kinda cute. Oh, when you're smiling me, you know.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, now the moment you've all been waiting for, the introduction to our bridal party. That's right. First up, coming in, we have Tatum Robinson and Tristan Walker.
I was saying, there's nothing more to me.
You're everywhere. You're everyone. You're everything.
Baby, don't pretend that you don't know it's true, 'cause you can see it when I look at you. And in this crazy life, and through these crazy times, it's you, it's you. You make me sing your every line, your every word, your everything. You're a carousel, you're a wishing well, and you light me up when you ring my bell. You're a mystery, you're from outer space, you're every minute of my everyday. And I can't believe that I'm your man, and I get to kiss you, baby, just because I can. Whatever comes our way, I will see it through, and you know that's what our love can do. And in this crazy life.
Chris and Amber, I just want you both to know how much I love you, how glad I am, Chris, that you picked a really good girl to be your bride, and how excited I am for the life that you guys are gonna share together. I love your family, Amber, I love you, and Chris, you are my heart. I love you, and congratulations.
Hey, Amber and Chris, I just want to tell you how much I love you, and have fun on your honeymoon. Wink, wink, give us some grandbabies, and you're awesome. Congratulations. Love you. Bye.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, if I have your attention up to the main table, our best man, Lance Robinson, is going to say a few things. Get you guys toasted.
I'd like to thank everybody for coming. For John Christopher Price, better known as Lunchbox. Yeah. His beautiful bride, Amber. All I can say is, knowing Lunchbox as long as I have, he's been with a lot of beautiful girls. I'm talking a lot of really beautiful girls. But, now it's time for him to settle down, gotta do a couple things. Couldn't have a better wife than Amber. Amber, you're very beautiful. You're the perfect match for Lunchbox, keeping him in line, under control. I love you, buddy. Congratulations. I'd like to keep this kind of short and simple. Most everybody here has a short attention span like the rest of us. I just want to say congratulations, buddy. I love you very much.
You're next.
It's going to be great. Yeah. I set an example for the rest of us, I think. Yeah. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. So I'm going to read it right from here. It says, Amber, I can honestly say you're my best friend. Siblings aren't as lucky as us to be so close. You have always been there for me no matter what, and you've made a huge difference in my life. You're an amazing sister, friend, and aunt, and you inspire me every day. I'm thankful you found such a great guy. You can thank Dan and I later.
You're welcome!
But seriously, you and Chris are a perfect example of what true love is, and it doesn't just happen in fairy tales. I can honestly say you two were made for each other. The relationship you have is based on respect, love, honesty, and you two complete one another. Congratulations, and I only hope that we can all be as lucky as you. I love you.
I take this minute.
She spends us as rivers to whatever song plays without a care in the world. And I'm sitting here waiting, the way that you were on my shoulders. It's been a long day and I'm still hard to do. She's pulling at me saying that I need you. There's a ball like a castle and I never ride it. And I need to practice my dancing. Oh please, daddy please. So I dance sit around while she's here. I know something the prince never knew. Oh, I dance Cinderella. I wanna miss you once more. Cause far too soon the clock will strike midnight and she'll be gone. She wants to know if I'm cruel or the dress. She says that the cross just won't leak away. And I need to practice my dancing. Thank you.
Put your hands together.
Here. Stay on, please. Christmas. She got the new candy, buddy. Alright, wanna vote on three? You wanna count down from three? Three, two, one? Alright. Ladies, let's don't get aggressive here, okay? You want that ring on it? We're gonna do this. Ready? Three! We need a chair on the dance floor for the next part. Oh, she's doing it all herself right now. Where's the groom? Where is the groom at? The group front and center. You gotta show us what you got, bud. It's time for that garter, bud.
People, we're very proud to know you. We're proud to be in your wedding and to many good years and making it through the rough ones. We love you guys and can't wait for Vince to finish his statement.
Yeah, forget all that because our son, he needs a friend or a girlfriend, so feel free to procreate all you'd like. We need to overpopulate Phoenix even more, so bring it on. Thank you guys. Love you guys. Congratulations.
And some words of wisdom. Amber is always right. So just forget the argument and you'll live a happy life.
Just call me and tell me about when you find out when you're right, Chris. Thanks, buddy. See ya. Show you better, do it.